I'm at least at back reporting.
It's that. Yeah. It's that, Juanito. It's that.
I was at the World Championships in Ireland, and I saw the and I said,
WBA Super World Champion Leo Santa Cruz.
Muy buenas tardes a todos, good afternoon everyone, and well, I'm just very happy, you know, I'm very happy to be back to fight here in LA, and you know, I owe all this to, you know, to my manager Al Heyman, you know, to all of you guys, to, you know, Richard, to Tom Brown from CGP, the watching team, you know, my family, all the people, all the fans that make this possible. You know, I'm just glad to be able to fight here in LA again. And like, you know, people that they were expecting for me to fight, you know, MMIs, but I don't know, for a reason, you know, and it happened. And you know, Chris Avalos is a fighter I know since an amateur, you know. I seen him fight there, he fought a couple of my, you know, teammates, he beat one of them. And then me and him fought when we were like 15, 16 years old, and we fought, it was a great fight, you know, tough fight. And people, a lot of people are saying that, you know, why take easy fight? This is no easy fight. I don't see no easy fight. I never underestimate no fighter. For me, every fighter that step up there in the ring with me is the same as tough as anybody else. You know, because anything will happen up there in the ring, you know. Richard, if you connect with Richard or anything, you know. And he's tough, you know, he's tough. I've seen him fight and he has good power. Out of 27 wins, he has 20 knockouts. So like I said, you know, I never underestimate nobody. I prepared, right now my focus is on him. We were training really hard for him. And we're gonna come really good, you know, we're gonna go out there, give a great fight. Like he said, you know, he come forward, I go forward. So it's gonna be a good little war. And hopefully, God, we get the win. We'll give you guys the rematch that you guys all want. You know, me against Adam Mares. You know, Mares is a tough fighter. You guys saw the first fight, it was a war, toe to toe. I respect him, you know, like I said, it was a pretty close fight. Thank God I got the victory. And now, you know, he could get the, you know, be able to take the revenge, that, you know, revenge, blah, blah, blah. But, you know, we're going to train. He has a great trainer, Robert Garcia, you know. He changed him, you know, in the first fight against me, you know. He balled and maybe people could say that that was a mistake, you know, that he should have boxed me. And then against Cuellar, you know, he boxed really good. He surprised all of us, you know. He did what he had to do. He was smart. And that makes it for an even better fight, if, you know, if we get the opportunity to fight each other. But right now, like I said, my focus is on Avalos, and it's gonna be a great fight, and we're just getting ready for that fight, and hopefully October 14th, we do a great fight for all the fans, and to come support us, and thank you, all of you guys.
Como yo siempre lo he dicho, yo nunca sobreestimo a ningún peleador. Mucha gente está diciendo, amor, que por qué tomar una pelea fácil o así. Digo, para mí ninguna pelea es fácil, para mí toda pelea es dura. Chris Avalos es un gran peleador, los conozco en amateur. Y es fuerte, viene a tú por tú y viene a dar una gran pelea. Como dicen, todo puede pasar arriba del ring. Nosotros nos preparamos en el ring para hacer la pelea fácil, ahí donde, como dicen, se ganan las peleas, entrenamos en el gimnasio fuerte, haciendo todo. Y como dicen, mucha gente estaba esperando la pelea contra Daniel Mares, y ojalá primeramente Dios, todo salga bien, salgamos victoriosos de esa pelea.
You heard it from Leo, you all heard it from Abner as well, what they really want, those two warriors, to fight each other. But on October the 14th, this is a must-win night, and I know for Avalos and Gutierrez, who's not here, but when they hear or read these kind of statements, that gives them extra motivation to upset the apple cart, as they say. So I know those two warriors here will not underestimate these opponents, and we as fight fans are going to be the beneficiaries of that. I know, and I don't like to guarantee, but I will guarantee in this case, we will see on October the 14th at the Stop Up Center toe-to-toe action. Double trouble in the Stop Up Center October the 14th for $30. Hope to see you all there. Thank you very much. We have one of the first fighters in here.
Thank you very much. Face forward, please. One fist up. Leo Chris, right here. Leo Chris, right here. With the trainers, please. Other way in the back, please. In the back one time, big smiles, TV cameras, please.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
We're going to have Abner in the red couches, Leo in the green couches.
Okay.
So, Robert, how's the press conference?
Great.
Ladies, how was the press conference?
Amazing.
Was it cool, short and sweet, to the point?
Great.
Leo. Do you remember when he used to manage you a long time ago?
Yeah, I remember.
How was that?
We were great friends, you know, and everything. We're still great friends and everything.
Him,
you know,
him and Mikey went together to sign with Top Rank.
We did, yeah, of course. Yeah, we did.
But how proud are you of him?
I'm proud of him, man. He's done so much better. When, you know, when he moved on, you know, I'm so happy for him. You know, for him, his dad. You know, we always wish him the best.
Nicest guy.
We were yet to fire. Now we're both together.
So last question, Leo, what says on your shirt?
No, it says Night Legend, something like that. I don't know, I just bought it because I like it.
That's why it looks like Mayweather's 50 and no shit. Thanks, Leo.
Are you supposed to go here?
I believe so.
Hey, how are you?
Were you going to sing today?
Huh? No, why?
You all dressed up.
You got to look good for the press conference, man.
Of course. Yeah, putting on a show. Why not? Looking good.
Yeah, thank you, brother.
Fui a ver a Remy el domingo.
Ah, sí me dije. Okay.
It's okay.
Which? You only have two or three fights. You're starting.
Four fights.
Who would you want to fight if you could fight anyone in your weight class? What weight class do you fight at?
He's probably going to kick me when I say this, but
no?
We fight at super welterweight to natural middleweight at 160. So anyone from 147 to 160.
Anybody can get it. You're the can man from Boston.
Yes, you could say that if you'd like. Yes, I'd
okay,
like
so who would you want to fight at 47? Who would you want at 60? Do you want the winner of Canelo Triple G?
Yeah, if that day ever came, I'd take it in a hot.
Okay, how about 47?
At 47, again, if we're just talking fantasy and anyone could come.
Floyd Mayweather.
Yeah, Floyd
Mayweather. Well, he's retired.
Shit,
Floyd so Mayweather. Next on line, Pacquiao.
He doesn't have to fight with a white guy with a lot of tattoos, though, has he?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, that could change everything.
Well, except Gotti. Arturo Gotti?
Angel left Freddy, but he was...
he's a white guy.
He's a white guy, yeah.
All right, there you have it. Another personality in the world of boxing. Stay tuned. BeastReport.com. I'm Mike Sigbeck reporting.
Let's take a picture of Richard.
I want Lopez.
Yes. Let's take a picture, Richard.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Let's
do it. I'll tell you what you can do.
All right, I'll see you later, Baker. Good to see you. Take care. See you later. Okay. Bye bye. Bye guys. Sure, sure.
Con confianza, güey, no tengas pena.
All right. Te veo en la.
Ya digo, estamos.
I didn't know you spoke Spanish.
Oh, come on.
I used to work for a radio station.
As a DJ?
Spanish speaker.
I didn't know that. You learn something new every day.
Huh?
I just know you were sparring Pacquiao, you were sparring Canelo.
I used to be on air in Vegas.
No way. That's awesome.
Yeah. All I want to say is aquí, nacido de
Cinco. You could do ringside, like, play by play. Oh, you guys are leaving us. I'll walk out with you. What's the one thing you take from sparring Canelo that helps you now in your career, that helps you?
Every sparring, I take a lot. I take the good with the good, bad with the bad. But with Canelo, I took timing. He showed me a lot about timing. Showed me a lot about it. You know, his experience, man. So yeah.
If he takes care of business, he is the face of boxing in millions, but he establishes himself. You think he's going to do it and take care of business against Triple G and he becomes the man in boxing?
I hope so. You know, but...
You could say you shared the ring with him.
Yeah, man. Not only that, he's a very... He's good for boxing. He's a very, very...
Good kid, good person.
Good person. Seems like a good family man. Yeah, so definitely he's good for boxing. Is what we need.
Chia, tell people where to follow you at.
At Chia Santana on all my social media.
And your prediction for Canelo Triple G, is a knockout decision or?
It's not going to scorecards.
Someone's getting knocked out.
Yes.
All right, you heard Canelo sparring partner. If he's report.com, I see back reporting. Hey, watch out, he chokes people out now.
No, 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 no.
That's true.
No. Tú y enojó cuando tú porque no me mencionó. Yo que gritándole, echándole carrilla al otro y nada.
No se escuchó nada.
Ni un pussy, ay, no quiero pussy, nada. Chale, la neta, siendo bien agüitada. Que no lo olviden que somos gente de M.
Casi me matas a mi peleador.
No pasa nada.
No pasa nada. Yeah, he almost, he did choke, choked my fighter Misael Rodriguez. He told this story, right?
No, what happened?
So I was getting wrapped and my fighter was sitting down and this guy just comes from the back and grabs Misael Rodriguez and starts choking him. And I didn't notice until someone taps me here and tells me, Abner, turn around. And I turn around and I shit you out, bro. Misael was like, he had a seizure, bro. Like,
wow.
He passed out and he was like, and I'm like, what happened to him? I thought he had like a heat stroke because it was so hot in there. And no, he told me that choked him
Juanito.
Out. Yeah, Juanito choked him out. So we picked him up. It was just like talking about 5-10 seconds.
Hey, Jose Aldo has a huge effect on people. Everybody thinks they're UFC superstar.
I know. Superstar. He was all happy like, "Dude, this is what Jose Aldo taught me," and it is what Jose Aldo taught him.
But not sneaking up on people when they're not. Now you spent a lot of time with Aldo. You were very patient with him. You stayed late 2 hours after working out yourself very, very hard. Why did you do that, Abner? You didn't have to do that.
Because he's a great person, man. He's a great person. Jose Aldo, he's a good friend now. And it just comes out of me, bro. I had to teach him. I saw things that I could maybe present, you know, tell him. And he's a good student. I'm gonna tell you that. So I'm glad I was able to add to his legacy because he's a legend. And you know, any little thing that I said it might help him later on in the future.
Last thing, you did something today that I've never seen in my life. There was a press conference. And all the shine is on Abner Mars, and he gives a shout out to Luyu Correa, your sparring partner. Nobody does that, Abner. Why did you do that? You didn't have to do it.
He came here for my press conference. He didn't have to either. He's helping me with the sparring. He's a great kid. I believe he's
3-0.
4-0. He's an outstanding amateur record, and he's helping me, bro. So giving him a shout out is just, you know, giving him that much. Energy, enthusiasm to become even better as a fighter. And I know he's going to get back to the gym, train harder, and become a great fighter.
There you have it, Abner Mars. Make sure to follow him on Twitter and Instagram at Abner Mars. And a big fight coming up October 14th at StubHub. You can get your tickets. They're going to be sold out. Only $30. FiestaRecording.com. Release it back recording. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FiestaRecording.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekback.